director of the Chicago Children's Advocacy Center. Good morning. Thank you for joining
us.
Good morning. Good morning.
Yeah, I noticed Janice Jackson, CPS, said that why do we need another sex abuse hotline? DCFS already has one. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, if they have one, it certainly appears that something isn't working. How many more days of Tribune headlines are going to have to be revealed to the people of Chicago before the parents of these public school children are going to feel confident in sending their kids to these schools? Something needs to be done.
Is there any accountability for people? You know, it goes back to City Hall. They're in charge of Chicago Public Schools. Where does the blame go up that high?
Well, the blame game, I think, can be played, and people will take advantage of these tragedies for political purposes. But what I'm trying to do is make sure that the people that I represent on the Southwest side, and we've got 26 schools in the 14th Ward, between grammar schools and high schools, public schools, charter schools, religious-affiliated schools. These parents need to feel that they're confident in having their kids in a safe environment, and they need to know about the Children's Advocacy Center and the ability of these families to get counseling if they need it, the ability of them to be confident that they can talk with people and have their children in an environment that's not going to intimidate them.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, you talk about the blame game, but there's a system problem here, and we turn to politics to solve these problems. And Mike Madigan says he intends to appoint an investigator, and the school district wants to hire its law firm. Does an investigation need to be more independent than coming from the government that messed it up in the first place?
Well, you hit the nail on the head, I believe, that the people have to be confident that this is not going to be an inquiry. I don't know that I want to use the word investigation. Mm-hmm. That is going to not just create the blame for the problem, but to immediately, right here and now, ensure that these families are going to feel that they have a resource to go to, like the Children's Advocacy Center, that is doing such a remarkable job. We need to get that information into the hands of the parents. And this coming week, in my neighborhood, we're going to have two conferences to bring the people from Mount Sinai in, bring the people from Mount Sinai Hospital, that is, mm-hmm. that also operates Holy Cross Hospital in the area, and the Children's Advocacy Center.
Shar, talk about what your group does. So if someone mm-hmm. calls this hotline, or what do you want kids and parents to know about your organization and how you can help?
Of course. Chicago Children's Advocacy Center is the only children's advocacy center in the city of Chicago. We do the collaborative investigations of child sexual abuse. So we co-locate with Chicago Police Department, DCFS, the Cook County State's Attorney's Office, and Strozier Hospital. We collectively and collaboratively investigate all reports of sexual abuse in the city of Chicago. So when they do get reported to the DCFS hotline or 911, they're immediately routed to our center, and our team together investigates these cases. So a few things we want people to know. First of all, if they call the hotline that Alderman Burke set up, they will be directed to immediately call the DCFS hotline if they're reporting abuse. If they get confused, if they're not getting what they need, as Alderman Burke mentioned, they can call us. We'll help them. We'll help them through the process. We'll assist them in those, just the legal processes. Call 911 if you need to, and then hook them up to resources, mental health counseling. We're encouraging all wards in the city of Chicago to reach out to us. We'll do training to their community members. We'll come out like we are in Alderman Burke's ward and help parents and community members understand what to do.
Legally, teachers and people in authority are supposed to report this. Are you angry that you hear this was not passed on?
Absolutely. I'm angry whenever I hear that mandated reporters are not reporting abuse. It's It's a problem that Dr. Jackson has acknowledged. It's a problem not only with Chicago Public Schools, but we see it in other areas where they're in youth-serving organizations where they have mandated reporters. We need to get that message out. 1-800-25-ABUSE, call. If you're having trouble, call us. We'll help you through it.
Thank you both for being here.
Thank you, Alderman.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And once again, bilingual sex abuse hotline number for the 14th Ward is on your screen, 312-919-2740.
Check of the weather now, Paul.
Yeah, hi, you guys. We have a-